Ananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militangena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Namaham Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namaste Sarasati Deve Gauravani Precharine Nirvisesha Sunyavadi Paschacha Desatarine Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadara Srivasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're hearing the transcendental qualities of Vritasura as he fights in battle against Indra, the king of the demigods.
我们现在聆听的是 Vritasura 的超然的品质，他现在正在和天堂的国王Indra正在打仗。
So Indra had come on the battlefield armed with a weapon given by the grace of Lord Narayan from the bones of Dadichi, the great yogi, the great sage.
Indra现在拿着Narayana给他的祝福的这一个武器，来到战场上，这个武器也是由这个圣人打地起的骨头做成的， 也是由于他的仁慈, 他把他的骨头给予了这个Indra。
And when the demons saw the power of the demigods, and they saw how Indra was so confident with this weapon, then the demons began to run away from the battlefield.
当那些恶魔看到Indra，他们以及那些半世人对他们所持有的这个武器感觉到非常有信心的时候，这些恶魔都逃散了。
And then the demigods, although the demons were running away from the battlefield, the demigods ran after them and tried to kill them from behind.
这些恶魔都逃跑了，即便这些恶魔都逃跑了，但是这些半神人都抓住他们不放，甚至从背后去攻击这些恶魔们。
So Vritasura pointed out to both the demigods and the demons that they were not fighting according to religious principles.
所以Vritasura就不仅指出了半神人，也指出了恶魔他们的错误，他们都没有按照宗教原则的
And Vritasura came in front of Indra and challenged Indra to fight.
And
we heard how Vritasura injured the elephant, which was the carrier of Indra.
我们听到了Indra的他的坐骑 是一头大象，非常庞大的大象。
So Vritasura was speaking very strong words to Indra because he knew that Indra had killed the brother of Vritasura.
Vritasura就对Indra说了非常严厉的话，因为Indra杀害了Vritasura的兄弟。
So Vritasura said, I have to get revenge for my brother. You killed him unfairly. My brother was your guru. He was your spiritual guide. He was your priest. And you killed him.
我的兄弟是你的灵性导师，他还曾经是你的技师，但是你却把他给杀掉了。
So Vritasura said to Indra, he said, you are naturally cruel.
So Vritasura told Indra, your nature is very cruel.
And if the other demigods follow you, then they will come and attack me with their weapons.
如果其他的那些办事人他们追随你的话，他们也会用他们的武器来攻击我。
But these demigods, they don't know about my power, my strength.
但是这些办事人却并不知道我的力量，我的力量。
If they attack me, I will cut off their heads with my trident.
如果他们来攻击我的话，我会用我的武器把他们全部都给砍掉他们的头。
And with their heads, I'll perform a sacrifice to the demigod Bhairava.
用他们的头，我会做一场祭祀，供给 Bhairava。
Bhairava is the leader of the ghosts.
Bhairava 是这个鬼魂的首领。
And I'll offer sacrifice to him, or to this demigod and all the other ghosts.
我会把你们所有这些半神的头去供奉给这个Bhairava 以及其他的鬼魂。
But Vritasura said, it may not be like that. He said, maybe you will cut off my head.
Vritasura 接着又说，有可能还不是这样的情况，有可能你会砍掉我的头。
Because you have that thunderbolt weapon, so you could cut off my head.
因为你有这个霹雳的武器，所以你有能力能够杀掉我的头。
And you could kill all my soldiers.
你甚至可以杀掉我所有的士兵。
So if you do that, Indra, I will take great pleasure to offer my body to other living entities.
如果你这么做的话，我也会很乐意把我的躯体献给其他的生物体。
To other people, other entities like the jackals and the vultures.
其他的生物体，比如说像豺狼和秃鹰等。
In this way, I will get free of any obligation to my karma.
就这样，我就可以免除我所有的业报反应的负债。
And it will be my good fortune to get the dust from the lotus feet of the great devotee like Narada Muni.
而且，我的好运将会是得到像。很伟大的奉献者，如南尔德穆里这样伟大奉献者莲花足下的尘土。
So the dust of the feet of the great devotee is very important, very powerful.
奉献者，伟大奉献者莲花足下的尘土是非常重要的，非常有力量。
So Vritasura, although he's in the demon body, he's showing that he's really a great devotee.
Vritasura 虽然是一个有恶魔躯体的人，但是他展示了他是一个非常伟大的奉献者。
Because he's desiring, he wants to get the dust from the feet of Narada Muni.
因为他的愿望竟然是想得到像 Narada Muni 这样伟大奉献者莲花足下的尘土。
Remember, in his previous life, Vritasura was Chitraketu, and Chitraketu.Had got mercy from Narada Muni.
Vritasura 的前世是 Chitraketu, 而 Chitraketu 得到了 Narada Muni 的仁慈。
So Narada Muni was like his guru in his previous life.
所以 Narada Muni 就像 Vritasura 前一世的灵性导师一样。
So although he had to take birth as Vritasura in a demon's body, he still thinks about his guru from his past life.
即便 Vritasura 在这一世投身有一个恶魔的躯体，但是他仍然记着他前一世的灵性导师。
Just like Jadbharat became a deer, but he could remember what happened his previous life.
就像 Jadbharat 虽然他成了一头小鹿，但是他仍然记得他前一世做过一些什么。
So the thinking of a devotee.Should always think that I am the servant of the Goswamis, the six Goswamis.
一个奉献者应该总是想着我是这些六 Goswami 的仆人。
And the dust from the feet of these great devotees are my five kinds of food.
而六 Gos 像这些六 Goswami， 他们莲花足下的尘土是我的五种食物。
One who is a devotee always wants the dust from the lotus feet of the past acharyas and Vaishnavas.
一位奉献者, 他总是渴望先前 acharya Vaishnava 足下的尘土。
So Vritasura was certain that he would be killed in the battle with Indra. He knew this was the desire of Lord Vishnu. So Vritasura was ready for death. And he knew that after his death, he was going to go back to Godhead, back to home.
他还知道当他死后他一定会回归守神回归家园。
So to go back to Godhead, that's the goal of life.
而回归守神是我们生命的目标。
And to go back to Godhead, you need to get the grace of the Vaishnava.
要能够回归守神回归家园,我们必须得到一位 Vaishnava 的仁慈。
No one ever went back to Godhead without the mercy of a devotee.
没有Vaishnava奉献者的仁慈或者恩宠，没有人能够回归守神。
So, it's mentioned in this particular section of the Bhagavatam that we have to get the dust from the lotus feet of the great devotees.
在圣典波迦瓦坛也提到过，我们也提到，我们必须得到伟大奉献者莲花足下的尘土。So
the word manasvinam, there's a great devotees always think of it. So great devotees means people who are always thinking of Krishna.
伟大的奉献者意味着他总是想着主 Krishna.
They are always peaceful. Thinking of Krishna.
他们总是平和平静，总是想着Krishna.
So because they're always thinking of Krishna, they're called Dhira. Dhira meaning sober, peaceful. Their minds are not disturbed.
因为他们总是想着Krishna，所以他们被称为Dhira. Dhira的意思是不受打扰的，平静的，平和的。
So the best example of a devotee is Narada Muni.
而一个这样的奉献者的一个榜样，最好的榜样的典范就是Narada Muni.
So if we get the dust from the lotus feet of a great devotee, then you can be sure to go back home, back to Godhead.
倘若你能够得到一个伟大的奉献者，他莲花足下的尘土，他一定能够重返家园，回归守神。
So Vritasura says to Indra, he said, oh, king of the demigods, Indra, because I am your enemy, I am standing before you.
Vritasura 现在跟Indra说, oh, 半神人的国王啊,我是你的敌人,我现在就站在你的面前。
So why don't you just throw your thunderbolt weapon at me now? Why don't you use it at me now?
你为什么不把你的霹雳的这个武器直接扔向我呢?
You already tried to attack me with your club, but that club was useless.
你之前用你的大头棒来攻击我，但是那个大头棒是没有效果的。
Just like if I was to ask money from somebody who is a miser.
就像我如果去找一个吝啬鬼要钱的话,
so you just used the club. You could have used the thunderbolt.
你因此你之前只是用了你的这个大头棒在攻击我，你并没有用你的霹雳来攻击我.
That club was just like, you know, that's not your real wealth. Your real wealth is that thunderbolt weapon.
你的财富不是你的大头棒。 你的真正的财富是你的霹雳，霹雳才是你真正的武器。
And if you use that thunderbolt, it will not be useless. It will not be useless. I'm sure you can kill me with that.
如果你用霹雳这个武器的话，我确保你这个武器不会没有效果。 他一定能够杀了我。
You shouldn't have any doubt about this.
你不要对此有所怀疑了。
So Indra, when Indra threw the club at Vritasura, Vritasura easily caught it with his left hand.
当 Indra 用大头把大头棒扔向 Vritasura 的时候 ，Vritasura 很容易就把大头棒给接了下来。
And when he got that club in his hand, he used it to injure the head of Indra's elephant.
当威彻苏拉把大头棒接了下来之后，他立马就反身扔给了他的扔向了大象的头，把大象给打了一下。
So Indra's attack was a big failure.
所以 Indra 在开始的攻击是失败的。
And Indra's elephant got injured and got pushed back 14 yards.
Indra 的大象也受了伤，被推后14码。
So although Indra stood with the thunderbolt in his hand, he was not very confident.
Indra 当时虽然还拿着皮，还，但他现在已经心存怀疑了。
He thought maybe the thunderbolt would also be useless against Vritasura.
他想有可能这个霹雳也会失败。
But Vritasura, he is a Vaishnava, and he told Indra.No, that thunderbolt weapon will not fail you. It's very powerful.
但是威彻苏拉作为一个 Vaishnava, 他向 Indra 保证这个霹雳不会没有效果，不会失败。
Vritasura knew that that thunderbolt weapon had been made according to the instructions of Lord Vishnu.
威彻苏拉知道这个霹雳是根据主威舍的训示而制成的。
So Indra had doubts. We could not understand that Lord Vishnu's order never fails.
Indra 虽然心存怀疑，因为他不明白主威士努的命令是永远不会失败的。
But Vritasura understood Lord Vishnu's purpose.
但是威彻苏拉他却知道主威士努的目的。
Vritasura was eager to be killed by the thunderbolt.
Vritasura 也非常渴望被主，被主被这个霹雳，主威士努制成的这训谕制成的这个霹雳给杀掉。
Because he knew that Vritasura knew that that thunderbolt had been made exactly according to the instructions of Lord Vishnu.
威彻苏拉他很确切地知道这个霹雳是由主威士努的训示而制成的。
And he knew that once he's killed, he was going to go back to Godhead.
他知道如果他能够这样被杀死，他一定能够回归守神。
So Vritasura was just waiting for the opportunity for that thunderbolt to be used.
威彻苏拉只是在等待这一个霹雳被释放的机会。
And so actually Vritasura was telling Indra, if you want to kill me because I am your enemy, so take the opportunity, just kill me.
所以威彻苏拉就告诉 Indra, 如果你想杀掉我的话，那就抓住现在这个机会杀掉我就好了。
You will get victory and I shall go back to Godhead.
你会赢得胜利的，而且我应该回归守神的。
And when you get victory, you'll be benefited. Both of us will be benefited.
当你胜利了之后，我们俩都会有益，都会有好处。
So do it immediately. Do it now.
那就快点行动吧，现在就做。
So Vritasura says, Indra, the thunderbolt.You carry can kill me.
威彻苏拉说：“你的这个霹雳是可以杀掉我的。”
It's been empowered by the prowess of Lord Vishnu.
它是被主威士努的英勇赋予的力量。
And it has the strength of the Dichi's austerities.
而且里面还蕴藏着打Dichi苦行的力量。
So you have come to kill me, according to Lord Vishnu's order. So I'm sure, and there's no doubt, I shall be killed by the thunderbolt.
因此, 毫无疑问, 我将被你的霹雳所伤。
Lord Vishnu has done this to help you. He's given you this to help you.
主 Vishnu 和你站在一边, 他是来帮助你的。
So your victory, opulence, and all the good qualities are guaranteed.
所以你的富裕, 胜利, 还有所有的优秀品质都是受到保证的。
So Vritasura was telling Indra, he was guaranteed, telling Indra, promising Indra, the thunderbolt was invincible.
Vritasura 向 Indra 保证, 这个霹雳是不可能失败的。
But he also encouraged Indra to use it against him as soon as possible.
而且他还鼓励 Indra, 请尽快地去释放这个武器。
So Vritasura was eager to die with the help of the thunderbolt.
Vritasura 是很希望、很渴望被这个霹雳所杀死的。
He knew it had been sent by Lord Vishnu.
他知道这是主威士鲁所派去的霹雳。
And by firing it, by releasing the thunderbolt, Vritasura knew that he could go back to Godhead.
如果能够被霹雳击中的话, 他能够回归守神, 回归家园。
And if Indra threw the thunderbolt, then Indra will win, he will get victory, and he will enjoy the heavenly planets.
如果Indra扔出了这个霹雳的话, 他将赢得胜利, 赢获得天堂的星球。
Of course, Indra will also have to stay in the material world. He have to stay in the world of birth and death.
当然，Indra还是留在着这个物质世界，留在这个物质世界意味着不断的生和死。
So Indra wanted to get victory over Vritasura.
但是Indra就是想战胜Vritasura.
And became happy. Indra was thinking that the victory over Vritasura, that he will be happy, but actually that is not all, that is not real happiness.
Indra 希望战胜Vritasura之后从而变得快乐，但是那样的快乐不是真正的快乐。
The heavenly planets are below Brahmaloka.
天堂星宿是在 Brahmaloka之下.
But in the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says, from the highest planet, Brahmaloka, down to the lowest, all are places of birth and death.
但是在主 Krishna描述, 从在博伽梵歌中描述到, 从 Brahmaloka 到 Indra 到所有的地下的这些低等星宿都会有轮转的生和死。
So he has to fall to the lower planets, birth again and again.
因此他必须回到这个低等的星球，不断的再一次的轮转生死。
But if he goes back to Godhead, he never returns to this material world.
但是当他如果能够回归守神的话，他再也不必重返这个物质世界。
So by killing Vritasura, Indra would not actually gain.
如果杀了Vritasura, Indra是不会得到真正的好处的。
He would remain in the material world.
他还会留在物质世界。
Vritasura, however, would go to the spiritual world.
但是Vritasura确实可以回归灵性世界。So
actually, the real victory would go to Vritasura, not to Indra.
所以实际上真正的胜利是属于Vritasura, 而不是Indra。
So Vritasura said to Indra, he said, with the power of your thunderbolt, I will get free of the bondage to material life.
Vishwasura 说，借着你霹雳的力量，我将免除物质的束缚。
I will give up this body and this world of material desires.
我将放弃这个物质的躯体以及拥有物质欲望的这个世界。
I can fix my mind on the lotus feet of Lord Sankarshan.
我可以将我的心意完全专注于主商卡山的莲花足。
And I will get the destination of the great sages like Narada Muni.
我也将去到像 Narada Muni 这样伟大圣人的目的地。
Lord Sankarshan has already said this, that I will get all that. So Lord Sankarshan has promised that I will get that destination.
主山卡山也承诺了我会得到这样的目的地。
So Lord Sankarshan, that is Chitraketu had been worshipping Lord Sankarshan.
因为在他的前一世 Chitraketu 他崇拜的是主山卡山。
Lord Sankarshan is the expansion of the Supreme Lord Balaram.
主山卡山是主 Balaram 的扩展。
So the most important duty, the most important thing at the time of death is to concentrate the mind.
死亡时最重要的事情就是专注心意。
It doesn't matter what the time is or what the place is.
这个不在乎到底时间是怎样，到底地点是怎样。
The important thing is the consciousness.
那一刻最重要的事情是他的意识。
So the mind has to be fixed on the Lord.
他的心意必须专注于至尊主。
So if we can fix our mind on the lotus feet of Krishna, or Vishnu, or Sankarshan, or any Vishnu Murti, then we'll be successful.
如果一个人的心意能够专注于主 Krishna, 主 Vishnu, 主 Sankarshan, 或者任何主 Vishnu 的 Murti 的莲花足，那么他的生命将会成功。
So to be killed while fixing the mind on the lotus feet of Sankarshan, Vritasura wants to be killed while his mind is fixed on the lotus feet of Sankarshan.
Vritasura 打算在被杀的时候将自己的心意专注于山卡上的莲花足。
So Vritasura is asking Indra, release your weapon now.
所以 Vritasura 就请求 Indra, 请现在就放掉你的这个霹雳的武器。
And Vritasura knew he was going to be killed by this weapon, which was given by Lord Vishnu.
Vritasura 他知道他一定会被 Indra 的这个武器所杀掉，因为这 Indra 这个武器是主 Vishnu 送给的。
There was no question, there was no doubt that that weapon would ever fail. It had to be successful.
这个武器是毫无疑问能够成功，能够胜利的。
Remember two reasons. One was the power of Vishnu, and the other was the power of Dadichi, the austerities of Dadichi.
我们前面也说过，这个武器能够成功的原因有两个。第一个是至尊主 Vishnu 的力量赋予在其中，第二个就是打地气的力量。
So Vritasura requested Indra to throw the thunderbolt now.
So Vritasura 就请求 Indra, 请立刻释放这个霹雳。
And Vritasura fixed his mind on the lotus feet of Krishna.
他也准备好了将心意完全专注于主 Krishna 的莲花足。
So a devotee should be always ready to give up the material body.
一位奉献者应该总是准备好要放弃自己的物质躯体。
So it's described as Gramya Pasha.The rope of material attachment.
这个被描述为叫做 Gramya Pasha, 就是物质依附的绳索。
The material body keeps us in the material world.
物质的躯体将我们保存，就是物质的躯体让我们留在了这个物质的世界。
So material body is no good. It's just bondage to the material world.
物质的躯体并不太好，它就帮我们捆缚在这个物质世界。
So we know the body is going to be destroyed one day.
我们知道我们的躯体有一天一定会被毁灭。
But people are so stupid, they're so foolish that they put all their faith in the body.
但是人们太过于愚蠢，他们把所有的信心全部都倾注在这个躯体上。
And they never want to go home back to Godhead.
而且他们从来都没有想过要回归守神，回归家园。
So people who fully surrender at the feet of Krishna are always thinking of his lotus feet.
那些完全臣服于至尊仁波首饰莲花足的人，他们总是想着主的莲花足。
And the Lord recognizes them, and he accepts them as his own personal assistants or servants.
而且主接受这样的人，把他作为自己的私人助手和仆人。
And the Lord never gives these servants the opulence of the material world.
主从来不会赐福这种仆人在物质世界的富裕。
He doesn't put them in even the upper planets or the lower or the middle planets.
就是不管这个物质世界的中等星宿还是高等星宿还是低等星宿，主都不会赐福这样的仆人他在物质世界的富裕。
So if we have opulence in any of these positions in the material world, then that will only increase our anxiety and our pride and our enmity, bad feelings.
当一个人有这样的一些财富的时候，很自然的就会增加他的敌意、焦虑、心意的打扰、骄傲以及好战。
Yeah. We have something material, we become very attached to it and easily become proud of it.
如果我们有很多物质上的财富的时候，我们会很容易就依附这些财富，而且会因为这些财富而感到骄傲。
So like these people go through, they make a lot of effort to increase and to maintain possessions.
他们的这些财富是倾注了他们巨大的努力去保持以及让它得到增长。
But then when we lose them,then we feel great unhappiness.
当他们失去这些财富的时候，他们会有巨大的不快乐。
So it's very important to understand the nature of the material world.
我们要了解物质世界的本性是非常重要的一件事情。
People work so hard to get material possessions, and when they lose them, they lament very much.
人们付出巨大的艰辛努力去获得物质的财富，但是一旦他失去的时候，他又会特别的悲伤。
We should understand this opulence of the material world will always be temporary.
我们要理解的是，物质世界的这些财富都是很短暂的。
So in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, as you surrender to me, I reward you accordingly.
主 Krishna 在薄伽梵歌中说，根据你向我皈依臣服的程度，我会相应的回报你。
Everyone follows my path.
每一个人都在追随我的道路上。
So both Indra and Vritasura are both devotees of the Lord.
Indra 和 Vritasura 都是主的奉献者。
And Indra had taken instruction from Vishnu how to kill Vritasura.
Indra 是从主 Vishnu 那里接受训谕， 得到建议去如何杀死 Vritrasura。
But the Lord was actually more favorable to Vritrasura.
但是事实上，主威士努却对 Vritrasura 更加的宠爱。
Because he knew after Vritrasura gets killed by Indra's thunderbolt, Vritrasura is going to go back to Godhead.
因为当因着杀掉威车苏热，用霹雳杀掉威车苏热之后，威车苏热就能够回归守神，回归家园了。
But Indra will win the battle, but he will stay in the material world, and he'll just rot in the material world.
虽然因着赢得这场战争的胜利，但是他仍将留在这个物质世界腐烂。
So both of them were devotees, but Krishna.Gave them different benedictions.
他们两个人都是主 Krishna 的奉献者，但是主给予他们各自不同的祝福。
Yeah, they wanted different things.
因为他们要的是不同的东西。
Vritrasura wanted to go back to Godhead, and Indra wanted to be king of heaven.
Vritrasura 想回归守神，而 Indra 就想要天堂的星球。
Vritrasura never wanted material possessions.
Vritrasura 从来都不想要物质的财富。
He knew the nature of material possessions.
因为他清楚物质财富的这种本性。
He knew that if you accumulate material possessions, then you have to labor very hard. You have to work very hard to keep them.
Vritrasura 清楚地知道，如果想要积累物质的财富。他必须非常努力的工作。
And when you get them, you make so many enemies also.
而且他如果获得这些财富之后，他又会增加很多的敌人。
So this material world is always full of this kind of envy and bitterness.
因为这个物质世界就是充满了各种各样的嫉妒和竞争。
If somebody becomes rich,His friends or his relatives will be envious.
如果一个人变得富有的话，他的亲戚朋友都会嫉妒。
And for people who are pure devotees, Krishna never provides material possessions.
而对主纯洁无瑕的奉献者，主 Krishna 从来不给他们提供什么物质财产。
A devotee.May sometimes need some material possession for preaching.
一些奉献者有时候需要一些物质的财富去传教。
But the possessions of a preacher are not like those of a karmi.
但是一位奉献者的财富，一位传教者奉献者的财富，不像功利性活动者 karmi 那样的财富一样。
The karmi gets possessions because of his karma.
功利性活动者，他的财产是通过他的业报活动而获得的。
But a devotee's possessions are arranged by Krishna.
而奉献者的财产是至尊人格守神的安排。
Krishna gives whatever the devotee needs for his devotional service.
Krishna 会给予。他的奉献者，他所需要的财富，为了他的奉献服务。
Because a devotee will never use his material possessions for any other purpose but for the service of Krishna.
因为一个奉献者从来不把这些物质的财富用于服务主之外的其他目的，他只是用这些服务主 Krishna.
So the possessions of a devotee are not like those of a karmi.
所以奉献者的财产和这些 karmi 功利性活动者的财产并不能相提并论。
Besides, Prabhupada went to the West. He didn't have any possessions.
我们记得圣帕帕德他去到西方的时候，他并没有财富。
But Krishna provided everything he needed to preach.
但是 Krishna 给他提供了他所传播 Krishna 直觉所需要的一切。
Krishna saw his determination, how much determined he was to preach. So Krishna helped him.
Krishna 知道他 ，Krishna 了解他的决心，所以他知道他需要多少去用来传教。
He sent people to provide everything.
他给他 主 Krishna 给他送去了人，然后送去了一切。
So Vritasura is speaking still, and he's saying to Indra, he said, the personality of Godhead does not allow his devotees to endeavor just for material sense gratification.
Vritasura 继续给 Indra 说，我们的至尊人格守神，他禁止他的奉献者毫无意义地去争取感官享乐。
There are actually four goals in material life.
在物质的生命活动中有四个目标。
First, there is religion, material religion.
一个是物质宗教。
Then there is economic development.
然后经济发展。
And then sense gratification.
然后是感官享乐。
So Krishna doesn't allow his devotees to get these material things.
Krishna 并不允许他的奉献者去 追求这些事情。
So we can just understand how kind Krishna is to his devotees.
我们由此可以推断主 Krishna 是多么的仁慈。
Vritasura is saying to Indra, you see how kind the Lord is.
Vritasura 就给 Indra 说，你想一想，我们的主是那么的仁慈。
So, but this mercy is only obtainable by the pure devotees.
而这种仁慈只能通过纯洁无瑕的奉献者。
People who have material gains, who want material gains, they will not get these things.
这种仁慈只能通过纯洁无瑕的奉献者获得，而这些想得到物质利益的人，他们不能够得到这样的仁慈。
So Indra is disqualified because he wants material gain.
所以 Indra 他是没有资格的，他想的就是物质的利益。
So material life, we said there are four goals in human life, four goals.
人生有四个目标。
There's material religion, economic development, sense gratification, and liberation.
物质宗教、经济发展、感官享乐以及解脱。
Liberation means to get free from material birth and death.
解脱意味着从物质的生和死当中解脱出来。
So people usually they want to get, you know, they'll be pious to get economic development, and with economic development they get sense gratification.
人们通常他会追求经济发展，追求经济发展之后他就想要感官享乐。
But a devotee only wants devotional service to Krishna.
而一位奉献者，他在这一生中只想要主 Krishna。
That's all he wants in this life, and in the next life also the same thing.
不仅在这一生，而且在下一生，他同样要的就是对主 Krishna 的奉献服务。
So the special mercy of the pure devotee is that Krishna saves him from hard work.
主对纯洁无瑕的奉献者的特别的仁慈，就是把他们从这种很努力的工作之中解脱出来。
Because people have to work very hard to get economic development and sense gratification, so Krishna saves them from that kind of work.
因为要得到经济发展、感官享乐，就必须很努力的工作。主 Krishna 把他从这种活动努力之中解救出来。
Of course, if somebody wants benefit, if somebody wants a benefit, then Krishna can give them but that kind of benefit.
当然，如果人有兴趣，有人有兴趣去追求这些财富的话，当然主也会让他们去追寻。
Just like Indra, he was a devotee, but he was not interested to get free from birth and death.
就像 Indra。他虽然是奉献者，但是他对从物质束缚的解脱并不感兴趣。
He wanted just to enjoy sense gratification and to live in the heavenly planets and to enjoy the opulence of heavenly planets.
他虽然是奉献者，但他只是想在天堂星宿，在这些地方进行高标准的物质感官享乐。
But Vridasura, he was a real pure devotee, and he only wanted to serve the Supreme Lord.
然而，Vritrasura却是纯粹的奉献者，他是真正的奉献者，他只想去服务至尊主。So
Krishna arranged for him to go back to Godhead.
所以主 Krishna 安排了他去回归守身，回归家园。And
he arranged for Indra to destroy his material body.
他安排了，而且他还安排了天帝Indra去毁灭他的躯体。So
Vritrasura is asking Indra to throw his thunderbolt weapon against him as soon as possible.
所以Vritrasura就要求，请求Indra，请尽快的释放你的霹雳的这个武器。And
then both Indra and Vritrasura will get what they wanted.
这样。 不管是Indra也好，还是Vritrasura也好，他们都可以得到他们各自想要的。And
they'll get their advancement in devotional service.
他们都会在他们的奉献服务之中获得进步。We
know Vritrasura is already very advanced, more advanced than Indra.
我们知道Vritrasura他当然比Indra要更为精进一些。So
Vritrasura will get the real goal of life, to go back to Godhead.
Vritrasura 得到了生命的最终的目的，他能够回归守身，回归家园。
So Vritrasura is speaking still to Indra. He says, oh, he's addressing the Supreme Lord. He said, this is Vritrasura praying to the Supreme Lord. He's saying, oh my Lord, oh Supreme Personality of Godhead, Will I ever be able to be a servant of your servants, of your eternal servants?
这个时候，Vritrasura就向至尊主献上祷文了。他在说：“哦，我的主啊，至尊人格守神啊，我还能够再次成为您莲花足下寻求庇护的永恒的仆人的仆人吗？”
I know your servants only take shelter at your lotus feet.
我知道您的仆人总是想去寻求您莲花足下的庇护。So
I want to be a servant of these servants.
因此，我想成为您这样的仆人的仆人。So
may I want to again become their servant, so that my mind will always think of you, the Supreme Lord.
只有当我还能够再次成为他们的仆人吗？这样的话，我的心意就能够恒常的想着你，专注着你。And
I'll remember all your transcendental qualities.
这样我就能够恒常的记忆着您超然的品质。And
my words will always glorify those qualities and
而且我的言语也会恒常的荣耀您的超然的品质。
And my body will always engage in the loving service of you.
而且我的躯体也会恒常的从事对您的奉献服务。
So, this is a prayer by Vritrasura.
这是Vritrasura献上的祷文。
And he's describing the real mood of devotion, devotional service. This is a proper mood of devotional service.
而且这是奉献服务之中应该所具有的恰当心态。
Yeah, pure devotional service is like this.
纯粹的奉献服务就应该像这样。
You have to first become a servant of the servant of the servant of the Supreme Lord.
我们先要想要成为至尊主仆人的仆人的仆人。
Just like we say, Das, Das, Anudasa.
就像我们经常说, Dasa, Dasa, Anudasa.
Meaning the servant of the servant of the servant.
这意味着就是主仆人的仆人的仆人。So
Lord Chaitanya taught us like this, and he also showed by his own example.
主柴坦尼亚马哈巴布也是这么教导我的，他以身作则这么做。
We should always desire to be the servant of the servant of the servant of Krishna.
我们应该总是想渴望成为至尊主 Krishna 仆人的仆人的仆人。And
that Krishna is the maintainer of the gopis.
主 Krishna 是牧牛姑娘的维系者。So
one has to accept a spiritual master.
因为这意味着一个人应该接受一位灵性导师。
Means somebody who comes in the disciplic succession and is a servant of a servant of the Lord.
人应该接受一位来自于是主仆人的仆人的这样的师徒传承的灵性导师。
And then when we work under his direction, then we must engage all of our body and our mind and our words in transcendental service.
之后，我们在这样的灵性导师的指导下，去将自己的躯体、心意和语言从事对主的奉献服务。The
body should be used in physical activity under the order of the guru.
躯体应该在guru灵性导师的指导下去从事实际的活动。And
the mind should think of Krishna.
心意应该是恒常不停地想着主Krishna。And
words should be used in preaching the glories of Krishna.
而言语应该用于传播主Krishna的荣耀。And
if we do like this in the service of Krishna, then our life is successful.
如果一个人这样从事对主的爱心服务的话，他的生命将会成功。So
Vritasura is still praying to the Lord.
Vritasura 继续向主祈祷，供奉祷文。
Says, Oh my Lord, that you are the source of all opportunities.
我的主啊，您是所有机遇的源泉。
So I do not desire to enjoy in Dhruvaloka.
我并不渴望在朱尔洛卡那里去享受。
Or the heavenly planets.
我也不想在天堂去享受。
Or the planet where Lord Brahma lives.
我也不想在主Brahma居住的星球那里去享受。
And I don't want to be the ruler of all the earthly planets or the lower planets.
我也不想成为地球、星球或者低等星球上的统治者。And
I don't want to be the master of mystic power.
我也不想成为那些玄秘力量的主人。And
I don't want liberation if I have to give up your lotus feet.
如果要我放弃你的莲花足，我也不希望解脱。如果要我放弃你的莲花足的话，我也不想，就是说我不希望解脱。
If I have to give up your lotus feet.
倘若不得不放弃了您的莲花足的话,
so a pure devotee will never desire to gain material opportunities.
一位纯粹的奉献者从来不渴望物质的获利的机会。
A pure devotee will not think that he does service to Krishna to get material benefit.
一位纯粹的奉献者，他从来不认为他做奉献服务是为了获得物质上的机会。A
pure devotee only wants to engage in loving service to the Lord.
一位纯粹奉献者，他总是在从事着对至尊主的爱心服务。And
he wants constant association of the Lord.
他会持续地与至尊主进行联谊。And
if he cannot be with the Lord, at least he wants to be with the eternal associates of the Lord.
如果他不能够持续地和主在永恒地在一起，他至少应该和主的那些同友们在一起。So
this is stated in many different places in the teachings of Lord Chaitanya and also in songs by Narottam Das Thakur.
这样的论述不仅在主柴他尼亚的教导中可以体现到，可以找到，也可以在纳尔塔曼达斯塔库的歌中体现到。
There's a well-known song which we sing. It says, "Tandara charana seva bhakta sanivas, janame janame hai abilas." The Narottam Das Thakur has written this beautiful Bengali song. It says, "To serve the Lord and the servants of his servants in the association of the devotees is the only objective of a pure devotee."
Narottam Das Thakur 在他的歌中这样说道，在奉献者的联谊中去服务主和他的仆人们的仆人是一位纯粹奉献者的唯一目标。
So somehow to be the servant of the Lord, and if we can't directly serve the Lord, then we can serve the servants of the Lord.
我们或者可以去直接服务主，如果不能够直接的去服务主的话，我们可以去服务主仆人的仆人。
We want to get that kind of association.
我们希望能够得到这样的联谊的机会。
So Vritasura is still praying. He's praying to the Lord. He says, "O lotus-eyed Lord."
Vritasura 继续向主祈祷道，哦，莲花眼的主啊。
He says, "Just like baby birds, they've not developed their wings. So they always wait for the mother to bring food and feed them."
就像那个幼鸟，刚刚出生的小鸟，它总是，它的羽翼尚未丰满，它总是渴望着它的母亲来抚，就是给它喂食。
Yeah, because the little birds, they can't fly themselves, so they're just in the nest. They wait for their wings to grow, and while they're waiting, the mother will bring food and feed them.
这些小鸟，刚刚出生的小鸟，它们的羽翼就是没有长好，所以它们只是在鸟巢中等待着它们的母亲。然后一边等待着，一边等待自己的鸟，等待自己的羽毛给长得丰满，一边就等待着母亲给他们喂食。
In the same way, little calves, they're tied with a rope, and they wait for the time of milking, when they'll be allowed to go to the mother and to drink some of the milk from the mother cow.
而且正像那些小牛犊在被绳子拴着。他总是在等待着能够去母亲去母牛那里喝奶的时候。
So when the cow is released, immediately he goes. The cow will go and the mother cow will give the milk, and the calf can drink the milk from the mother.
当小牛犊的绳子被解开了之后，他会立马冲向他的母亲那里去吸吮奶汁。
Or another example is.It's about the wife whose husband is away from home. So she always longs, when will my husband come home and satisfy the wife?
而且就像离家的丈夫在家等候的这个妻子，她总是在这个妻子总是在家里焦虑的等待着，在家里总是渴望着我的丈夫什么时候能够回来。
So Vritasura offers these three examples.
Vritasura 描述的这三个例子。
He says, "In the same way, I always want the opportunity to render direct service unto you."
Vritasura 举出了这三个例子，他然后说道，同样，我也很常的渴望祈求能够为您做直接的服务。
Pure devotees always want to associate personally with Krishna.
一位纯粹的奉献者总是很常的渴求能够与主亲身的联谊。
They want to give service to him.
他想给主一些服务。
So the examples given in this verse very nice.
这里举出了三个例子，非常恰当。
The small baby bird practically never satisfied. The mother's always got to bring food to feed the baby birds.
那个在鸟巢中的幼鸟、小鸟，它总是不会满足，它总是渴望它的母亲能够回来给它喂食。
So when the mother comes, then the little birds, they get their food, they're happy.
当它的母亲回来的时候，这个小鸟能够吃到食物，它就会非常的快乐。
The same way the little calf is not satisfied until he gets to suck the milk from the mother's udder, from the udder of the cow.
而一头小牛犊，除非能够吸吮到它母亲，它母就是母亲的乳汁，否则它也不会满足。
In the same way, the chaste, devoted wife is waiting for her husband to come home. She's never satisfied.Until she gets her husband back.
同样，一位贞洁的妻子，除非她得到她丈夫的怜悯，否则她也不会满足。
So these are very nice examples given.
这些都是非常好的例子。
Maybe we'll just read the last verse to finish the chapter.
好，我们现在把这个诗节，这一章最后这个诗节读完。
So Vritasura says, Oh my Lord, my Master, I am wandering through this material world.
Vritasura 继续说道，哦，我的主啊，作为我作为功利性活动的，我在这个物质世界漫游。
Yeah, this is the result of my karma. I'm wandering in the material world.
我留在这个物质世界是我功利性活动的结果。
So I just want friendship in the association of your devotees who are all pious and enlightened.
我只是在寻求您虔诚的或虔诚的奉献者的涟漪之下的友谊。
My attachment to my body and to my home and children and wife.That's continuing by the spell of your material energy.
我对躯体、妻子、孩子和家庭的依附，在您的外在能量的迷惑下持续着。
But I want to be attached to them. I don't want to be attached to them any longer.
但是我再也不想再依附他们了。
Just let my mind and my consciousness and everything I have be attached only to you.
就让我的心意、我的知觉和我所有的和我拥有的一切只依附于您吧。
So this is Vritasura's wonderful prayers to the Supreme Lord.
这就是 Vritasura 献给主的非常好。非常优美的祷文。
We say Vritasura is the hero of the Bhagavatam.
我们说 Vritasura 是 Bhagavatam 的英雄。
Because he's showing us such a wonderful example of pure devotional service.
因为他向我们展示了纯粹奉献服务非常好的榜样。
So it's very nice to hear these prayers of Vritasura. Read them again and again.
让我们能够非常，我们能够聆听他的祈祷文，非常的好。希望我们能够再一次又能聆听他的祈祷。
So I'm very happy I had the opportunity to read them with you.
我也非常幸运，非常非常快乐的能够和大家一起来读这个。
Okay, are there any questions today?
Yes. First question from.现在我们来回答问题啊。First question from Chandra Vinasini Dasi. Hare Krishna Gurudev, 请接受我卑微的顶拜一切荣耀归圣帕帕的请教咕噜。我们传播圣名的时候，物质传播的对象人，一切都是 Krishna 提供给我们的。那么是不是可以这样理解 ,Krishna 服务我们更多，我们的服务建立在 Krishna 给予我们的基础上。感觉太亏欠 Krishna 了，这样的心态正确吗？感谢 Guru 的仁慈。Hare Krishna, Guru Day, 请接please accept my humble obeisances, all glory to Srila Prabhupada. I want to ask Guru, when we preach preach the holy name, the objective and the the people we preach and everything are offered by the Lord Krishna. So can we understand like this, Krishna serve us more than us. Our service is based on the Krishna's foundation that Krishna gave us. So this kind of mood is right?
Well, yes, I guess, yes, it's all right. Krishna provides, we said that, Krishna provides. According to your surrender and your pure desire.
是 Krishna 提供的，这个是根据你的纯洁的愿望，你的渴望。
And your motivation has to be to please Krishna.
你的愿望应该是要去取悦 Krishna.
So Krishna knows the heart of every devotee.
Krishna 知道每一个奉献者的内心.
And he's watching us, and he knows what we need and what we're trying to do.
Krishna 在观察着我们，他知道我们每一个人到底需要什么，我们应该做什么。
So we have to just surrender to Krishna. We have to endeavor, constant endeavor.
我们需要臣服 Krishna. 我们需要持续不断的去努力。
Now, you have to understand that Krishna may not immediately reciprocate with us.
我们需要了解，也许 Krishna 不会立刻的接受我们。
Krishna may test us before he fulfills our desires.
Krishna 会在满足我们的愿望之前检验我们。
So it's not such an easy thing to know what Krishna wants to do for us.
要了解 Krishna 要对我们做什么不是一件容易的事情。
We say man proposes and God disposes.
我们常说人在想然后天在看。
事在人，谋事在天。
成事在人，谋事在天。
Okay.
Next question.
Yeah.
Next question from Zhen Zhen. Hare Krishna, 亲爱的 Guru Maharaj, 请接受我卑微的礼拜，一切荣耀归于爸爸，一切荣耀归于您。时间观念不强，每天的事情安排没有章法，想改变，渴望提高做事情的质量，可是内心软弱无力，怎么办呢？ Hare Krishna, please accept my humble wishes. All glory to Srila Prabhupada, all glory to you. I don't have a strong sense of time. I have no rules in my daily schedule. I want to change. I'm eager to improve the quality of the doing all the things, but my heart is very weak. What should I do?
Make your heart stronger.
那就让你的内心强大起来。
I think you're making an excuse. You say my heart is very weak. That could be just an excuse on your part.
我想你说你的心意，你说你的内心很软弱，这句话其实是一个借口，为你找了一个托词而已。
We have to become more determined that we really want to do service for Krishna.
我们需要是非常有决心，真正的想要为 Krishna 去做服务。
It's very easy to say, oh, my heart is very weak.
我们要说我们的内心很软弱，这是一件很容易的事情，每个人都可以说我们都很软弱。
Krishna is not going to be very happy with that kind of talk.
Krishna 不会满意于你这样的说辞。
If you're going to do something for Krishna, you have to be very serious.
如果你想要为 Krishna 做一些什么事情的话，你得非常认真起来。
You should make all efforts to do it.
你需要准备好，你需要付出所有的努力去为之奋斗。
But if you just say, "Oh, my heart is very weak."
What、如果你只是说我的内心很软弱，那又怎那能怎么办呢
？We say it's like we say, mind is willing but body is weak, or but sometimes we say the body is willing but the mind is weak, or something.
有些时候说我们的力不从心。
So you have to consider very carefully. What do you want to do for Krishna?
所以你要再仔细的想一想，我想要为 Krishna 做什么呢？
You have to get your mind under control.
你要把你的心意拿回你的控制之下。
Cannot just be making excuses. Oh, my heart is very weak.
你不能只是找个借口说我的心意就是那么的软弱。
So you have to make your heart strong. How do you make your heart strong? By doing more chanting, by hearing more, by surrender.
那么你就要让你的心意变得强大。如何让你的心意变得强大呢？通过臣服，通过更多的念诵。Next question.
Yes.
Next question from Janaka Prabhu. Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru Dev. 请问 Vaitrasura 战死能够回归守身的原因，是因为要被主的霹雳武器所杀才能够回归吗？如果 Indra 用其他的武器将他杀死的话，他是不能够回归的，所以他恳求 Indra 释放霹雳武器，而不是其他武器来攻击时马上受死。Hare Krishna, basis to Guru Dev. I want to ask, the reason why Vaitrasura can go back to the Godhead because of the thunderbolt weapon and not other weapon. If the Indra used the other weapon to kill the Vaitrasura, then the Vaitrasura cannot go back to Godhead. So the Vaitrasura request the Indra to use the thunderbolt weapon, not other weapons.
No, not necessarily true.
不一定是这样的。
Prabhupada is writing like that in the commentary, but it's not necessarily exactly like that.
圣帕帕德在要旨的评论中是这么说的，但是不一定是这样的。
Of course, if Indra does use the thunderbolt, then it's more likely that it will go back to Godhead.
如果 Indra 用这个霹雳的武器，他是更有可更就是更回归守身的。
But Vaitrasura is going to go back to Godhead, whether he's killed by the thunderbolt or not.
但是 Vaitrasura 是一定能够回归守身的，不管 Indra 他是用霹雳还是用其他的武器。
Krishna wants to take him back to Godhead.
因为主 Krishna 就想把他带回守身。
Krishna arranged that he got cursed. He got the demon body.
Krishna 安排了这一切，他得到诅咒，然后得到了一个恶魔的躯体。
So Krishna arranges for everyone the results of their past activity.
Krishna 为每一个人安排好了一切，他过去的是怎样，他未来的是怎样。
So Krishna arranged for this Vaitrasura to go back to Godhead in this very special manner.
Krishna 为 Vaitrasura 安排好的这样一个特殊的情况。
And he's also giving a lot of mercy to Indra, purifying Indra.
而且他还给予了 Indra 很特别的仁慈，让 Indra 得到了净化。
Indra is appreciating that he's really a good devotee, and he's much better devotee than Indra is.
而且他非常，欣赏这个Vaishrasura, 他觉得 Vaishrasura 是比 Indra 更好的一位奉献者。
So it's not easy for Indra to kill Vritasura.
因此，对于 Indra 来说，并不那么容易能够杀掉 Vaishrasura。Next question.
Yeah.
Next question from Yogita Sharma. Hare Krishna, Gurudev. Please accept my humble obeisances. Ogala Krishna Papa. Gurudev and Gauranga. Oh, we have heard in so many classes on how we must consider ourselves as servant of the servant. We will never qualify to be the director servant of the Lord. To be humble, one must have the thinking of wanting to be the servant of the servant. Despite of these kind words guiding us on how to become humble, I'm still have this feeling of somehow, even if it is very tiny service, even if it is very tiny service, but want to be able directly serve the Lord. See his beautiful smile and so many other such feeling, Gurudev. Despite of wanting to be servant of the servant of the Lord, feelings for direct service are there. Is it because I'm not yet humble enough, or yet full of too much pride? Hare Krishna, Gurudev, 请接受我卑微的礼拜。我在我们的课程中听说过，要如何将自己视为主仆人的仆人。我们永远没有资格成为主直接的仆人。谦卑的仆人有时候想成为仆人的仆人的想法，尽管有这些善意的话语指引着我们如何去改变，变得谦卑，但是我还是有一种莫名的感觉，哪怕是很小的事情，也希望能够直接的去侍奉主，看到主美丽的微笑，以及许多其他类似的感受，Gurudev。尽管想成为仆人的仆人，但还是想有直接服务的感觉。这是因为我还不够谦虚，还是太骄傲的？就是简单的说一下这个 Mother 姐的问题，就是说，她虽然听到了要成为仆人的仆人的感受，但是心里还是想去直接的服务主。她想问的问题是，她的这种感觉是不是代表了她不够谦卑，或者说太骄傲了？还是 Krishna？
Well, it may be that you're too proud and that you're too puffed up, that you want to be directly serving Krishna, but it may be pure devotion. I don't know. I have to understand more what your thinking is.
就是这种感觉有可能是你骄傲的，有可能是你不够谦虚，也有可能是纯粹的奉献服务。我不知道具体的情况是怎样，所以我要了解的是更多。
Certainly, we were just hearing from Vritasura that he desired to be the servant of the Lord and to associate with the servants of the Lord.
今天当然我们听到的是 Vritasura 他的祈祷文中，他希望能够和主的奉献者联谊，希望成为主仆人的仆人。
So we say first deserve, then desire.So if you're qualified to desire, first you have to deserve that. You have to really show that you're genuine, that you want to be the servant of the Lord.
如果你渴望的话，首先你要值得这个，就是说你要值得这个水平才行，你要具有这个资格。
So you serve the deities. The Lord is there for you in the form of your deity. You're worshipping the deity, and you know you're already serving the Lord there in his deity form.
比如说你想去服务主，主其实就直接的在你面前，他是直接在你的面前，你也是在直接的服务他，服务神像，就是服务神像的时候。
So.You have to work on the basic sadhana. You have to get your motivation right. You have to have the proper qualification to desire these things. You're desiring all this, so you have to have the proper qualification for that.
你需要有好的，你需要在你的sadhana的规范修习上下功夫，同时你要端正好你的动机，然后变得有资格才行，去有这样的渴望去直接服务主。
Now usually we don't get to directly go and serve the Lord right away. At first we practice on serving a lesser person.
通常我们不是去直接服务至尊主本人，而是服务他，间接的去服务他，通过一个人去间接的服务他。You
don't get, just like if you work in the service of the king, you don't get to immediately go and serve the king, but you will practice serving, you know, a lesser, a minister of the king, or another secretary of the king. Maybe you'd be the servant to him, and you'd serve him. And when the secretary or the minister sees that you're a good servant, then he may recommend you to the king.
通常我们不是直接的去服务主，就像我们经常举的一个例子，打一个比方，就是我们如果要去国王那里服务，去直接的服务他。 我们不是直接的先去服务国王，而是去服务国王的秘书或者他的身边的仆人，去通过服务他的秘书在那里练习，然后这个他的秘书觉得你非常好的话，他会向国王推荐你来服务国王。So
you have to be prepared to accept, you know, you shouldn't think that I'm only going to serve the Lord. You should be willing to serve also the other devotees, and then gradually you come to the level of being able to serve the Lord.
我们开始也不是去直接的服务主，而是要去准备，而且要有这样的心态，不要有这样的心态，就是说我只是去服务主。我们应该有的心态是我想要去服务主的奉献者，然后通过去服务主的奉献者，再上升到 能够去直接服务主的层面。
So the process is to be the servant of the servant many times the servant.
因此这个程序是成为仆人的仆人很多次之后。
We don't say just only servant of Krishna. We say servant of the servant many times the servant.
我们的程序是仆人的仆人的仆人，后面有很多有个仆人，然后 很多次之后，然后再慢慢的到 Krishna，我们不会直接上来就说我是 Krishna 的仆人。And
if Krishna thinks you're qualified, then Krishna will call you forward. He will say, Yogita, Yogita Mataji, you come and do this service for me. You come and cook for me, or you come and clean for me.
如果 Krishna 觉得你 OK 非常不错的话，他会直接的叫你说 OK。 好, Yogita Mataji, 请来直接为我做饭吧。So,
you have to attract the attention of Krishna by your mood of service and surrender.
因此, 通过你的臣服以及你的服务来吸引Krishna的注意力吧。Okay,
yes.
Next question from Yuna. Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, and the dear devotees, please accept my humble obeisance, all glory to Srila Prabhupada. Why did Indra get a reaction for Vishwasura's killing? He was doing his duty when he fought Vishwasura. Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, 请接受，还有各位奉献者，请接受我卑微的顶拜，一切荣耀归于圣帕帕德。 为什么Indra得到一个业报反应，就是说要去杀Vishwasura呢？他在从事着他的职责去和Vishwasura作战。Yes,
but remember, Vishwasura, first of all, he's a Brahmana, and he's a great devotee.
我们记得Vishwasura他是一个婆罗门，他是一个奉献者。
And so you don't get away with violence. You do violence to anybody, anytime, you get reactions, even if it is your duty.
我们不会说，就是说只要是有暴力，我们就会有业报反应，不管它是不是你的职责。
So you want to be, devotees are very cautious, very careful not to use violence unnecessarily.
所以奉献者会非常的在意，不要不必要的去使用暴力。
And if you do use violence, you have to do some atonement afterwards to purify yourself from it.
如果你从事了一些暴力活动的话，你必须为此做出一些忏悔的活动。
Even though you say, well, it's my duty, I had to do it, you know.
即便你说，哦，这是我的责任，这是我的职责，我必须从事这样的活动。
But still you have to purify yourself from the reactions of the karma, the reactions using violence. You can't just say it's my duty.
所以你必须为你所做的这个暴力活动承担一定的业报反应，即便它是你的职责。
Even nowadays they say if the father beats the child, then the child can call the police.
在现在，就像如果有父亲去打孩子的话，这个小孩他是可以叫警察的。
Or the mother, the same way the mother starts beating the child can call the police. My mother's beating me.
或者说这个母亲在打孩子的话，这个小孩子也可以去叫警察，说我的母亲在打我。
And the police will come, and you'll get trouble.
这个警察就会来，然后你就会有麻烦。
You could say, well, it's my duty, it's my child, I have to beat them.
你虽然可以说，哦，这是我的小孩，我的职责就应该去管教他，去打他。
But you'll get punished, you'll get reaction.
但是你会得到麻烦，你会有反应。
You may have to go to court, you may have to pay a fine.
你也许会去到法院，然后也许会为此支付一些。
So you have to be very careful what you do.
因此你要特别在意你到底做什么。
Lord Parasurama, he killed the Kshatriya race, I think it's 21 times.
主 Parasurama 杀掉了这些刹帝利21次。
Now the Kshatriyas, they were all sinful people.
这些 Kshatriya 都是一些罪恶的人。
But after Lord Parasurama killed them all, he had to go and do atonement, penance, to purify himself.
当 Parasurama 杀掉了所有的刹帝利之后，他也在做一些忏悔的活动，来净化他自己，净化他的罪，他的这些业报反应。
So Indra, he killed Vritasura, but Vritasura was a great devotee.
Indra.是去杀 Vritasura， 但是 Vritasura 是一个伟大的奉献者。
You kill a great devotee, it's very bad. You get heavy reactions for that.
他杀掉了一个伟大的奉献者，所以他的业报反应是非常大的。
Of course, Vritasura wanted to die. He wanted to be killed.
当然 ，Vritasura 他是想要被杀掉的，他也想被 Indra 杀。
But still, Indra has to get reactions from it.
但是仍然，Indra仍然需要为此承担业报反应。
We can escape the law of the government, but you cannot escape the laws of the Supreme Lord.
我们可以逃脱掉政府的法律制裁，但是我们无法逃脱掉至尊主的法律制裁。
The laws of the Supreme Lord are very exact.Nobody gets away. Everybody gets their due punishment, what they deserve.
至尊主的制裁，法律制裁是实实在在的存在的，没有人能够逃脱得掉。
So you should be very careful to always act properly.
因此，你要非常的小心和在意，而且恰当的行为处事。
When you do something which is not proper, then be prepared to get reactions for that.
如果你做的事情不恰当的话，那就准备好去承担这样的反应。
Okay.
Next question from Radhisham. 顶拜 Gurudev, 顶拜翻译，顶拜所有的奉献者。 请问有相同物质主义倾向的奉献者，资深奉献者接受他们的素食，而我是拒绝他们做的素食。物质主义者喜欢吃他们做的素食，这样的奉献者，物质主义者喜欢吃他们做的素食的这样的奉献者，并不讲喜，并且讲不喜欢我这不吃那不吃的，讲我走火入魔了。我吃了他们的食物，会有不良反应，可这些资深奉献者却没有反应。我想知道我的问题出在哪？顶拜 obeisance to good day and all the devotees, I think this question like this. I want to ask. Some senior devotees accept the material people and relatives, there's vegetarian food, but I didn't accept these relatives' vegetarian food. And some senior devotees also criticized me, said I'm practice not right. Because when I eat the vegetarians by these material people, I have some better reactions. But these senior devotees eat this vegetarian food. They don't have any reactions. I don't. So I want to know what is my problem. Gurudev, can you understand?
Well, I don't know. It's pretty chiguai.
simply say like this.
Yeah, other people eat the food. Other people eat the food, and they don't have any problem with it. But she eats it. She has a problem with it.
Yes.
So why? She's asking why.
Mm.
Well, one reason is because you're used to eating your own food. You're not used to eating other people's food.
可能一个原因是你经常吃你自己做的饭，你并不太习惯于吃别人所做的饭.
And these other people, they're eating out all the time. They often eat all different people's cooking. So they eat something and it doesn't bother them because they're used to eating all different kinds of people's cooking.
而这些吃别人的东西没有什么反应的人，这样的人他可能经常在外面吃，所以他在外面吃的时候，这样外面的一些食物对他来说并没有什么打扰。So,
I would see it like that. I think it's just something which, you know, people's tongues become accustomed to certain kinds of food.
有一些时候就是这样，有一些人他的舌头已经非常习惯各种各样的食物了，就是说他已经就是没有什么反应的。So
you're certainly used to eating, you know, your own cooking.
你当然是非常习惯于你自己的烹饪的。So
difficult for you to eat somebody else's food.
当然。 要让你吃别人做的饭，是不那么容易的。But
somebody else, they may have difficulty to eat your cooking. Maybe they cook for themselves, they eat their own cooking. If they try to eat your cooking, they may find it difficult.
如果其实还有一种情况，就是有一些人如果他吃你做的饭，有可能也会出现类似的情况，他并不习惯于吃你做的饭。
Because some people, they never eat out. They always eat at home.
因为有一些人他不喜欢在外面吃，很少在外面吃，他们大部分就是在家里吃。
So they're used to eating the same kind of cooking.
他们习惯于吃相同的食物。
It's difficult for them to eat some other person's cooking.
让他们去吃别人所做的食物就是很难以接受。
They don't like it.
他们不喜 不接受。 Good day. In her question, have some details. Some senior devotees say, if you don't eat this food. It seems your practice is not properly, maybe. So he didn't know why.
Senior devotee said to her, if you don't...
Yeah, because the senior devotees, they accept this kind of the vegetarian food by the material people, but she cannot accept it. So the senior devotees, why you not can accept it? Maybe your practice are not properly.
Well, who are the senior devotees? What makes them senior?
所以你要问一问, 这些资深的奉献者是谁? 而什么让他们变得资深呢?
Yeah. You know, some people, they may be senior in age, or they may be senior by initiation. Doesn't mean they're senior in realization, or senior in their standard of devotional service.
有一些人资深, 他是资深, 只是他的年纪, 或者说他的启迪, 但是并不意味着他的觉悟或者说他的奉爱服务的标准是很资深的。
You are, Radhisham is also a, you are also a senior devotee.
Radhisham, 你也是一个资深的奉献者。
So I'd be more, I'm not, I don't know why they said such things to you like that. It's not very nice things to say.
我不知道他们为什么要对你这样说，但是如果对你这样说，并不是一件很好的事情。
Anyway, don't take it too seriously. Don't worry about it.
因此，不管怎么样，不要对这件事情特别在意，不要担心这样的事情。
You're a good cook. You cook nicely. People like your cooking. That's enough.
你是一个好的厨师。 你人们喜欢你的烹饪，这就够了。
Don't have to worry about eating other people's food.
不要想着去吃别人的这个食物，出现这样那样的问题，不要去想这些事情，不要担心这样的事情。Next question from Das. 顶拜咕噜的莲花族顶拜所有的翻译和所有的奉献者，请问咕噜。 奉献者与 Krishna 的五种关系都是 Vatsala 的品质吗? 比如 Krishna 与 Yashoda 妈妈, 勾皮姑娘等等。 A basis to Guru's lotus feet, I want to ask a Guru, the relationship between the devotees and Krishna, the five relationships are all belongs to Vatsala qualities, like the Krishna, between the Krishna and Yashoda and the Gopis.
Well, of course, the gopis, they're not in Vatsalya Ras, they're in Madhurya Ras.
Gopi Gunyang, Taman, Yu Krishna, Shi, Madhurya Ras, are Bush Vatsala Ras. Just Taman, the Guanxi, Bush Vatsala Ras, Shi, Madhurya Ras.
But one who is in Madhurya Ras, it includes also Vatsalya Ras.
Ranar, Rugo, Yiga, Renho, Krishna, Shi, Madhurya Ras. 而 Madhurya Ras 它是包含着 Vatsala Ras.
But Sakya Ras is not equal to Madhurya Ras or Vatsalya Ras.
而 Sakya Ras 就是中性的，这种关系并不包含 Vatsala 这种关系。
And Dasya Ras is also not equal to Vatsalya Ras.
Dasya 就是仆人的这种关系也不包含瓦萨拉的关系。
In Vatsalya Ras, one is very anxious to protect Krishna, to maintain Krishna, and to feed Krishna, and dress Krishna, and these things.
Vatsalya Ras 这种父母之爱是他希望保护 Krishna, 给 Krishna 穿衣服，然后维系 Krishna, 是这样的一些品质在里面。
But in Sakya Ras, they're just friends who play with Krishna.
而 Sakya Ras 这是一种朋友的关系，而朋友的关系它更多的是和 Krishna 在一起玩耍。We
see when Agasura came in Vrindavan, and all the cowherd boys walked into the mouth of Agasura, and they thought Krishna will save us if there's any problem.
当阿嘎苏拉摩来的时候，所有的牧牛童全部都进了森林，他们想的是，哦，我们如果出了什么问题的话， Krishna 就会来救我们。
But in Vatsalya Rasa, Mother Yashoda is always trying to protect Krishna and to do things to save Krishna and protect to help him. Like when Krishna killed Agasura, Mother Yashoda did many rituals just to protect Krishna and to purify him.
而在 Vatsala 这个关系之中，母亲亚修达她所有的心态是想保护 Krishna， 而且想为 Krishna 做一些什么事情。比如说当阿嘎苏拉摩被杀掉了之后，她就想为 Krishna 做各种各样的仪式来净化主 Krishna。
Yeah.
OK. Next question from Leela Avatar Madaji. 顶拜 Guru，翻译和所有的奉献者莲花族顶拜咕噜，请问为什么说 Hare Krishna mantra 里面包含有音节 Om， 具体是哪个音节包括呢？ Obeisance to Guru and all devotees. I want to ask, why do we say the Hare Krishna Maha mantra includes the syllable Om? I want to know which syllable include the Om.
Om itself is a syllable.
Om 这个单词就是一个音节。
Om is the sound representation of Krishna.
Om 代表了 Krishna 的这个音阵。
So the holy name of Krishna includes Om.
所以主 Krishna 的圣名包含了 Om。
Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita,Pranava Sarva Vedeshu. I am the syllable Om in the Vedic mantras. So Om represents Krishna. It's the sound representation of Krishna.
在薄伽梵歌中，主 Krishna 说：“我是音节 Om， 所以 Om 代表了主 Krishna。”
So when we chant Krishna's name, that's not different from Om.
所以当我们唱诵 Krishna 的名字的时候，唱诵 Krishna 的时候，它和 Om 也没有区别。
But we don't chant Om, we chant Krishna's name. Krishna is more pleased to hear his name than to hear Om.
但是我们并不唱诵 Om, 因为 Krishna 他更希望我们唱诵他的名字，他更希望我们唱诵直接的称呼 Krishna.
You're not going to get love of God by chanting Om.
我们不会通过唱诵 Om 来得到对 Krishna 的爱。
But if you chant Hare Krishna, you can get love of God.
但如果我们唱诵 Hare Krishna 的话，我们能够得到对神的爱。
So to chant Om, you have to sit. You have to sit stiff, quiet.You have to sit and control the mind and senses.
因此，如果你要唱诵 Om 的话，你得安静的坐着，平静的坐着。
But in chanting Hare Krishna, we can chant and dance in ecstasy.
而我们在唱诵 Hare Krishna 的时候，我们可以又唱又跳，在狂喜之中。
So we experience more bliss, more love for Krishna.And chanting Hare Krishna.
我们在唱诵 Hare Krishna 的时候，会充满着更多的极乐，更多的奉爱对于 Krishna.
Okay.
Okay. Next question from Vaishnavi Vani Madaji. It is amazing that Vishwasura is remembering his guru, even though he didn't meet Narada Muni in this demon body. His third birth, he was King Chitraketu. Then he became Vidyadhara, and now in the third birth, he became a demon. Did the Lord Indra also improve spiritual The after killing Vichasura, I too wanted to pray like Vichasura. There is always unexpected hindrance in preaching and devotional service. I sometimes fear about this and pray to Lord Nrisimhadeva. Thank you, Guru Maharaj. 非常令人惊奇的是 ，Vichasura 在这一生，即便都还记着他的咕噜，即便他是在一个恶魔的躯体。所以第一个问题是，这是不是他的第三世 ？Good day.
Is it the third birth?
Yes.
Yes.
是的。
Yes. As you said, he was Chitraketu, then he became a Vijayadara, and then he took birth as Vritasura. So as Chitraketu, he had met Narada Muni.
就像你说的，他这是他的第三世，他先前是 Chitraketu， 然后是 Vijayadara， 而现在是 Vritasura。在 Chitraketu 的时候，他遇见了 Narada Muni。And then, did Lord Indra also improve spiritually after killing Vichasura?
Well, Lord Indra had to do a lot of austerity after he killed Vichasura.
When Indra 杀掉了 Vichasura 之后，他得做很多的苦行。
He had to go for a long time. He was in a lotus. He had to sit inside a lotus flower, hiding himself. He had to do a lot of atonement after killing Vritasura. So he didn't get spiritual benefit. He got a lot of reactions and he had to atone for that.
他杀掉了 Vritasura 之后，他得做很长时间的苦行和忏悔。他在一个莲花里面躲着在。所以这并不是一个灵性进步，它是一个忏悔苦行，一个净化。
Yeah?
And, I too wanted to pray like Vichasura. There is always unexpected
hindrance
in preaching,、
yeah.
in preaching and devotional service. I sometimes feel about and pray the Lord Shiva. 就是我也像 Vichasura 一样祈祷，在传教和灵修的服务之中，总会有意想不到的阻碍。我有时会对此感到恐惧，并向主力辛哈 Deva 祈祷。谢谢，谢谢 Guru Dev。Okay. Last question.
Yeah.
没有，不是问题，好像。
下一个。
Last question. Next question from servant. I think is Satyamaji. 顶拜 Guru Maharaj 和所有的奉献者，请问 Guru Maharaj， 我们在服务的时候总是根据自己的喜好去做服务。例如我就是喜欢做饭，联谊的时候就愿意在厨房里服务，或者我就是喜欢学经典，联谊的时候就愿意分享讲课等等。而我不喜欢的服务就没有愿望做，这种服务心态对吗？是经过慢慢的进化来改变呢，还是根据自己固有的本性做自己喜欢做的服务呢 ？Hare Krishna. This question from Satyamaji. Obeisance to Guru Dev and all the devotees. I want to ask Guru Maharaj. When we do devotional service, should we do what we like? For example, if I like the cooking.If I like cooking, then when the association come, I just cook in the kitchen. If I like the sutra, I will share the lectures. If I don't like some service, then I don't have desire to do. So I want to ask, this mood is right?
Well.Not 100%. The mood should be to do whatever is necessary.
这个不是百分之百正确的。正确的心态是我们做必要的服务，就是说哪里需要我们，我们就去做什么。
Not just,
okay.
Not just only I like in the kitchen, I'll go in the kitchen.
不是说我喜欢厨房，我就只在厨房。
You should do whatever. Sometimes it's necessary to be with devotees, especially somebody who's a senior devotee. They need to show the example by being present at the program and taking part in the activities like the arti and the kirtan and sitting and hearing the class.
对于一个年长奉献者来讲，有些时候非常重要的就是在年谒的活动中要出现，不能只是在厨房待着，你要在 arti 在 kirtan 在大家讲课的过程中要出现，要呈现一个榜样，大家也需要你的这个联谊，就是在这个过程中。So then she asked, if not right, if this mood not right, then it should be purified slowly and slowly, step by step, or should we do the service based on our nature?
Well, of course, if you do the service based on your nature, that's very good, but you have to consider what needs to be done, time and circumstances. You can't just say, oh, it's not my nature, I don't do that. You know, you have to consider, is it necessary? Is it, and nobody else to do it? You may have to do it.
如果说你能够根据自己的本性去做喜欢的服务，这当然是一个很好的，但是也要根据时间、地点和情况看哪些东西是需要的。如果在那个时候、那个恰当的情况下没有人做，需要你做的话，你就得去做。OK. Next question.
Yeah.
Next question from Suda Sindhu Devidasi. Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj and all the devotees. Sometimes when we eat outside, although it is a vegetarian food, the cook may have different consciousness. So will the food affect our consciousness? Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, 请接受所有的奉献者。有些时候我们在外面吃的时候，即便是素食的食物，但是那个厨师可能有不同的知觉，所以这样的食物会不会影响我们的知觉？
Oh yes, definitely.
当然会影响我们的知觉。
Devotees should be very careful, try to avoid eating food cooked by non-devotees.
奉献者应该很小心的去避免去吃那些非奉献者所做的食物。
You should make arrangements to cook for yourself.
你应该做出安排去自己给自己烹饪。
Eat food cooked by non-devotees certainly will influence your consciousness.
如果是非奉献者做的食物，它肯定会影响你的知觉。
下一个问题。
Here another question. 仆人说，顶拜古鲁，请问夫妻吵架，丈夫野蛮，会有业报吗？可以报警吗？ Obeisances to Guru, I want to ask, if the couple they are fighting, the husband are very not polite, very, so they have a reaction, can we call the police? Violence, if the husband has violence.
Now, if the husband's violent, if he hits the wife?
He didn't give the details.
Well, yes, it's not very good. You know, we're talking about things in the Western world. I don't think you can do much in countries like China.
在西方呢，在西方，他们对这个东西很严重，就是说在中国可能情况不一样。He asked, there is some karma in this fighting?
Yes.
是有业报的。
Devotees, we should be careful what we do.
奉献者应该小心我们所做的事情。
Fight people, certainly, it's not nice. It's not the mode of goodness. You're cultivating the mode of passion and ignorance.
吵架肯定不是奉献者应该培养的品质。这个是属于愚昧心态。奉献者应该培养善良心态。
So if you act in the mode of passion, it results in distress.
如果你是在激情形态中活动，会给你带来沮丧。
And if you act in the mode of ignorance, it will bring you, take you to hell.
如果是在愚昧形态中活动，会把你带向地狱。
So we should be very careful what we do.
因此，我们应该非常的小心我们做什么事情。
Every action will be a reaction.
一切的活动都会有业报。
Unless it's devotional service.
除了奉献服务。
So you cannot say arguing with your wife or fighting with your husband or whatever. That's not devotional service. It's not devotee behavior.
因此，不管是丈夫跟妻子吵架，还是妻子跟丈夫吵。这些都不是奉献者的举止行为，这些都不是奉献服务。
The devotees have to behave like devotees.
一个声称是奉献者的人，应该要有奉献者的行为举止。
Proper behavior, proper action.
恰当的行为，恰当的举止。
Okay.
Okay. No more question.
Okay. So, woman can share Subhuti, right?Prabhu ke vaman jantai de fan im, am ganshya soy de fang shen se ling ting ti wen. Vaman jufu ni man shang ho kwai la, wan shi ru yi, chuan jiao shun li. Shri la Prabhupada ki, jai.
Jai, Hare Krishna, ganshya guru de.